المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم اجعل تجمعنا هذا تجمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما، إنك ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. أما بعد، we are still at سورة البقرة at ayah 168, and in the previous ayah we talked about the concept of tawheed, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states that there is none worthy of worship but Him. And we mentioned that as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us, أَصْدَقُ الْحَدِيثِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. The most truthful of all statements is لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And we also mentioned that لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ is the source of all good. In other words, anything that is good that we do, the source of which is لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, and without of which, none of that good is acceptable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also mentioned that the heaviest in the scales of hasanat of the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment is la ilaha illallah, and because of la ilaha illallah the heavens and the earth were created, all of mankind were created. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the prophet and the messengers, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended all of the divine revelations for this statement, for this kalima, la ilaha illallah. After that, after stating and asserting that this is the ultimate statement of truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ كُلُوا مِمَّا فِي الْأَرْضِ حَلَالًا طَيِّبًا وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. O mankind, O people of faculty, O people of intellect, كُلُوا مِمَّا فِي الْأَرْضِ حَلَالًا طَيِّبًا. Eat from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed for you on earth. Halal means sharia compliant, permissible. طَيِّبًا. What was mentioned in the hadith that is mentioned in Sahih Muslim and at-Tirmidhi, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the tongue of His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, relates to us the message, إِنَّ اللَّهَ طَيِّبٌ لَا يَقْبَلُ إِلَّا طَيِّبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all pure, and He will not accept anything less than that which is all pure. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِمَا أَمَرَ بِهِ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the believers with the same thing that He commanded the messengers. فقال يا أيها الرسل كلوا من الطيبات واعملوا صالحا إني بما تعملون عليم. O prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, eat from that which we have put for you, from the طيبات, from that which is good. واعملوا صالحا, and perform your righteous deeds. إني بما تعملون عليم. Indeed, I'm the all knowing of that which you do. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, and this is something for us to really pay very, very close attention to. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this hadith, he says, وَإِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيُطِيلُ السَّفَرَ أَشْعَثَ أَغْبَرُ يَمُدُّ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ يَا رَبُّ يَا رَبُّ. This hadith teaches us that when one is traveling, as this man is mentioned in the hadith, يُطِيلُ السَّفَرَ, traveling for a long time, يَمُدُّ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ, raising his hands to the heavens. أَشْعَث, meaning that his hair is not groomed, is not well taken care of, an implication of traveling. أغبر means his hair is dusty. You know, obviously there is no rest areas in the desert and, you know, in places that have taken, that travel has taken place in the past. The only thing that prevents his dua from being accepted is what the Prophet ﷺ tells us, وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَشْرَبُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامٌ وَغُدِّيَ بِالْحَرَامِ فَأَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. The only thing that prevents this dua from being accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is this person is either eating that which is not permissible, that which is forbidden, or the source of which is forbidden, meaning the money that has been this good has been purchased with is not money that is lawfully earned, you know, by this individual. وَإِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيُطِيلُ السَّفَرْ أَشْعَثَ أَغْبَرْ يَمُدُّ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ يَا رَبُّ يَا رَبُّ وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَلْبَسُهُ وَمَشْرَبُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامٌ وَغُدِّيَ بِالْحَرَامِ فَأَنَّى يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. Another hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, أَيُّمَا جَسَدْ غُدِّيَ بِالْحَرَامِ فَالنَّارُ أَوْلَى بِهِ. That whichever a body that's been nurtured and nourished by that which is forbidden, again, either the source of which is forbidden or the food itself is forbidden, it's not sharia compliant, فَالنَّارُ أَوْلَى بِهِ means the hellfire is more worthy of this, you know, body. So this is something that we ought to pay very, very close attention to. I'll mention a third hadith where Sa'id ibn Jubayr رضي الله عنه, and we all know who Sa'id ibn Jubayr is. Sa'id ibn Jubayr asked the Prophet ﷺ to make dua for him that his dua would be accepted. Means that the dua of Sa'id ibn Jubayr, when he makes dua, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts it. The Prophet ﷺ said, Ya Sa'id, أطب مطعمك تكون مستجاب الدعاء. أطب مطعمك, make sure that what you eat is lawful and the source of which is lawful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your dua. ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. So after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to eat from that which He placed on earth for us, حلالا طيبا, permissible, and it's good for us, meaning that there is no harm in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislated nothing that will harm us physically or mentally or any other way. And that's the meaning of the word طيبا. And then He says, ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. Because as we'll see in future ayat in other surah, where the shaitan has given, it has whispered to his followers to make certain things halal, and to make certain things haram, and to make certain things halal for themselves and for their spouses, you know, haram. And of course, as we know, the rule of which, الحلال ما أحله الله ورسوله والحرام ما حرمه الله ورسوله. That which is halal and permissible is that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has made halal and permissible. And that which is haram and impermissible is that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has made forbidden and not permissible for us to deal with or eat from. Anyone who tries to override this legislation exits the state of Islam. Exit the state of Islam into a state of apostasy, wal-iyadu billah, because here they are challenging the Creator, the one and the only one, and the legislator of that which is permissible and that which is not permissible. إِنَّمَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالسُّوءِ وَالْفَحْشَاءِ وَأَنْ تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. That Satan will command you to do what? Su is the opposite of hasan. So su is something bad, sins. Al-fahsha ma azuma mina al-dhamb, meaning that which is even greater than sin, like the kaba'ir, like zina, fornication, drinking alcohol, stealing, murdering, dealing with riba. These are among the mubiqat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us at the time of His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that these will destroy the believer. As-sab' al-mubiqat, the seven that are mentioned in the hadith. إِنَّمَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالسُّوءِ وَالْفَحْشَاءِ. And furthermore, which is greater than سوء الفحشاء, وَأَنْ تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. This is among the gravest or the most despicable and the most gruesome type of sin that one would make a statement against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be it speaking of His physical qualities, be it speaking of His divine names and attributes, being attributed anything to Him that is not attributable to Him, or being negated something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has affirmed for Himself in the Qur'an and or in the Sunnah. This is among the greatest of all kabair. So we cannot make any statement against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unless He has affirmed that for Himself. And the safest, you know, route to follow is the route of the prophets and the messengers and the scholars thereafter, that we do not utter any statements against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unless we have concrete evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah that this is an appropriate statement to be attributed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ اتَّبِعُوا مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ قَالُوا بَلْ نَتَّبِعُوا مَا أَلْفَيْنَا عَلَيْهِ آبَاءَنَا أَوَلَوْ كَانَ آبَاؤُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ. And if they are told, and this has been revealed in the disbelievers, and some said in the Israelites, and some said in the mushrikeen at large, that if they were told, اتَّبِعُوا مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ, follow the guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, they said, no, we follow what our forefathers have followed. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a rhetorical and exclamatory type of statement, says, أَوَلَوْ كَانَ آبَاؤُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ. Even if the case, as it was, that their forefathers, they neither comprehend, they neither understand, nor they follow the guidance, nor they are guided. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَثَلُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, give an example of those, be it those who have been followed, or those who are following, without guidance. He gives the example, وَمَثَلُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا كَمَثَلُ الَّذِي يَنْعِقُ بِمَا لَا يَسْمَعُ إِلَّا دُعَاءً وَنِدَاءً. And the example of those who disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the example of the dawab, the animals. That they simply hear a sound, Or in another interpretation, like the example of the idols, who neither hear a sound or anything for that matter, are unable to respond. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, صُمٌ بُكْمٌ عُمْيٌ فَهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. Sum cannot speak. Sum cannot hear. They cannot hear the guidance. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not negating or criticizing the fact that somebody doesn't have the ability to hear, you know. But he's criticizing the fact that the hearing has been given to an individual and he's not using it for what they're supposed to use it for, which is to receive the guidance. Bukm, they're unable, again, if they're unable to hear, they're unable to paraphrase or speak the truth or speak from a paradigm that reflects the truth. Because their frame of reference is corrupted. Their frame of reference is based on, you know, kufr, disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shirk, hypocrisy, so on and so forth. So here they're unable to, you know, paraphrase or speak the truth because they're unable to have that value system and that paradigm through which they see the truth. Summun bukmun umyun, they are, you know, blind. They're like the blind person, not a person who has lost his eyesight, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَلَ أَبْصَارُ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَلَ قُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. So here they're unable to see the truth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in many examples, in the Qur'an says, even if they were to see one miracle after another, وَلَمْنْ أَتَيْتَهُمْ بِكُلِّ آيَةٍ, even if you bring them every ayah, and every ayah is inclusive of every ayah that can possibly be brought to them, they shall not become believers. So they are unable to use this eyesight to see the truth and to believe and to witness the ayat of the presence and the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reiterates the statement, Ya ladina amanu. The first statement was, O mankind. The second statement is now more focused on the believers. Ya ladina amanu. In other words, if you iman, as you claim, is truthful, كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Eat nothing but that which is طَيِّب. Eat nothing but that which is good for you, and from halal sources, and in and of itself is permissible, is halal. يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Eat from that which we have blessed you with, the sustenance. وَشْكُرُوا لِلَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ إِيَّاهُ تَعْبُدُونَ. And render shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you claim that you truly worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. All you who believe, eat from that which is good that we have bestowed upon you. Obviously the disbeliever, they eat the sustenance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended upon them. However, they worship others. And in the hadith, even the inanimate objects, like the sea and the mountains, and so on and so forth, would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, the sea would say, Oh Allah, allow me to drown the son of Adam. Why? أَكَلَ رِزْقَكْ وَعَبَدَ غَيْرَكْ. He ate your sustenance, and he worshipped somebody else. Similarly, the mountains, دَعْنِي أُطْبِقْ عَلَى ابْنِ آدَمْ. Oh Allah, allow me to come tumbling down upon the son of Adam. Why? أَكَلَ رِزْقَكْ وَعَبَدَ غَيْرَكْ. He ate your sustenance and he worshipped some other entity, some other, deity. يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِلَّهِ. The peak of ibadah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the people of Dawood, اعملوا آل داود شكرا. The peak of ibadah is that we are rendered the due gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In good times and in bad times. In good times by rendering the due ni'mah, that is due for, you know, this bounty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, we perform the deeds of ibadah to reflect our gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that we worship none but Him, recognizing that this ni'mah came from none but Him. اعملوا آل داود شكرا وقليل من عبادي الشكور. We want to be among those who are few. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, about them, they're qaleen, they're few. وَقَلِيلٌ, because this is the peak of ibadah. And we also want to render the ibadah of sabr, persevering patience upon tragedies, calamities, loss of limb, loss of health, loss of loved ones, tribulations, so on and so forth. That's also another form of, you know, ibadah that is highly like to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the believer is always between these two ibadat, the ibadah of sabr, and the ibadah of shukr. Ibadah of sabr upon calamities, tribulations, trials, right? And the ibadah of shukr upon bounties, you know, having children, having health, having wealth, all of that. So we're doing these two ibadah until we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا الذين آمنوا كلوا من طيبات ما رزقناكم واشكروا لله إن كنتم إياه تعبدون. This is the true demonstration of one's action of their proclamation of the shahada, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. And of course, the best of shukr is to always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says, فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who often remember him and render the due gratitude for all of his bounties. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cause us to live as Muslims and to die as believers. أقول قولي هذا واستغفروه. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك ومن طاعتك ما تولي ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا أبدا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا اللهم نسألك الرضا بعد القضاء وبرد الحياة بعد الممات والنظر إلى وجهك الكريم في غير ضراء مضرة ولا فتنة مضلة إنك ولي ذلك والقادر عليه جزاكم الله خيرا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.